Well, SCRAMSPACE has now been going for almost 3.5 years. And in that time, there's been so much that's been achieved. We set out to build a talent pool, to build capability, and to conduct a lot of research. And we've done an enormous amount of that in multiple institutions in Australia and also across the world. Many of the PhD students were directly supervised by some of the core flight team. So what they got out of it was direct insight into the practical application of their research. And I know for a fact that many of them found that extremely inspirational. The reason why we do scramjet research in the first place is because rockets are fundamentally fragile. They're systems that are pushed to the extreme and they're not as reliable as they could be. Scramjets have the potential to be reusable. They have the potential to increase safety and reliability and to cut the cost down as a result for future satellite launch. So that's why we do scramjet research. And our flight experience only spurs us on. Science, if it means anything, is hard. It's very, very important to be pushing up against the boundaries, and that's what we were doing in this project. The scramjet payload that we developed was ready to fly. It was fully functional, it was operating, and it was like a Formula One car. On launch day, we had a fully functional payload sitting on top of two rockets. At ignition, the lower stage rocket failed. There was a blowout of the rocket nozzle that led to significantly reduced performance of the rocket, very unstable flight, and the end effect was that the scramjet payload and the rockets splashed into the ocean not too far from the launch site. As a result, we could not conduct the experiment as planned. The flight data that we obtained was very, very important in many ways. It's proved that the design that we came up with was strong, it was robust, it was ready to perform scramjet experiment, but it's also provided insight into various other aspects of high-speed flight, particularly from the engineering point of view. We'll reconstruct what took place in the flight. We'll learn a vast amount from that, and that will feed into the ongoing research at the University of Queensland, and in particular is going to help ensure that UQ maintains its position as the world's leading university-based hypersonics research group.